SMB Connect, India's largest integrated solution platform which connects SMEs and entrepreneurs across the nation. Despite several government initiatives and programs, Indian entrepreneurs and SMEs are still facing many challenges. Our mission is to help them overcome those by acting as a catalyst in propelling business growth, promoting innovation, technological advancement and digitalization, and making them successful global players. We have devised 5 pillars to stimulate productivity and growth of SMEs. Start, Manage, Expand series, annual knowledge event series organized concurrently in different cities of India, Advaita, to recognize and celebrate women entrepreneurs of India. Accelerate, entrepreneur awards to honor excellent and accelerating businesses. Listing services, provide a platform to expand digital footprint and customer outreach. Advisory services, help SMEs deal with industry-specific challenges and accelerate growth. Nationally recognized and well-acclaimed in India, SMB Connect is an industry pioneer that supports SMEs. By providing strategic and innovative end-to-end solutions, together let's help small businesses overcome all odds and succeed, because small can be big.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and very warm welcome to all of you in 2021's probably the first webinar. Definitely the first for myself and most of the panelists here. I hope it's the first webinar and it's quite a learning experience for all of you and all of us here at SMB Connect. So this webinar is about promotion of the ebook which we have brought about on last week on 29th of December. We launched it. So ebook on Year Plan 2021, Vision 2025. It has contribution from 25 odd authors talking about what should be the game plan or what should be the strategy for businesses in the COVID hit, the post-COVID era, or currently the way we are functioning in our business environment. So before I talk about this particular conference, let me introduce myself. My name is Sandeep Andre. I am founder of SMB Connect. We are one of the largest SME network, business network across India. Prior to the COVID and lockdown, we have organized over 100 conferences across different parts of India and had interacted with multiple SMEs and businesses, entrepreneurs, and helped them in networking and grow their businesses in some way or other. As part of our support to the SME world, we have created a website called Local and Vocal Online, which is a website to promote local organizations. We request these businesses to please list your services, business or products on this website as currently available free, so that it can be seen by all the SMEs across different parts of India. So as we all know, COVID-19 has impacted business, and which has actually paused the thinking process of many businesses and business owners, which is where we thought to bring out this ebook called Game Plan 2021 and the Vision for 2025, where we have requested 25 our authors to share their experiences, how a business should do their thinking, how their business should do the decision making in this pandemic hit economy. I have a panel of four eminent personalities who have contributed on this particular ebook, and let me introduce each one of you to you. So first, let me welcome Mr. L.V. Rajan Kolath. He is managing partner of Kolath & Company and a transformation consultant at Venture Bloom, a Singapore-based organization. He is a director, transformation consultant, chartered accountant, international business consultant, and financial advisor to reputed corporates, NGOs, banks, and organizations at domestic and international level. He is a passionate entrepreneur with over 2 decades of experience in his capacity to audit advisory and international business consulting. In short, he is a techno-financial professional with vast knowledge and expertise in corporate structuring, merger and acquisitions, technology collaboration, raising funds, finance, economics, and economics for attaining sustainable growth and value creation. So welcome, Rajan, and thank you for being on this particular session. Next, I would like to welcome Nitin Dakshane, a very good friend of mine. He's a highly accomplished professional with over two decades of experience spearheading businesses and revenue expansion of various IT software and logistics organizations across India. He's a keen strategic and implementer with strong business acumen, having comprehensive experience in evolving strategy, business development procedures, product roadmap, engagement strategy, and service standards in potential market. He is an expert in Six Sigma, project management, logistic, and supply chain management, a former cricketer, a life member of DDCA, and has represented his current and past organization as keynote speaker in over 100 of cities in India. So welcome, Nitin. Next, I'd like to welcome Dr. Deen Dayal Swami. He is currently leading as the director of Rajalakshmi School of Business in Chennai, a PhD from Central University, an alumnus of Emeritus Institute of Management, Singapore, and Columbia Business School, USA. He is a leading motivational speaker, ICF certified life coach from USA. He's a professor, author, speaker, coach who has distinction of delivering over 2,000 odd motivational sessions, trained more than 50,000 corporate executives, both in public sector and private sectors. So he's also a member of the Odisha State Bar Council. That's something I didn't know. So Dr. Dindyal Swain, please welcome on this panel. And last but not the least is Mangal D. Karnad. She is co-founder of Fabulous Square, which is a full service marketing agency. She has over three decades of experience in diverse areas like software development, business development, marketing. Worked for nearly 10 years with Tally, played a key role in positioning Tally as one of the leadership and thought leaders in the industries. Everybody is aware of what Tally is, and I don't think there's a single business who have not used Tally in from that right from the time of the inception. She's the recipient of Most Talented CMO of India in 2014. Apart from certified coach, Mangal has been trained in time management, NLP, creative writing. So, ladies and gentlemen, these are our guests, panelists for the session. So, let's not waste our time and let me start the discussion by asking our expert what they have contributed and share a few of their thought processes on this. So, let me start with Nitin. Nitin, you've been talking about, you've talked about digital transformation in your article. So can you, how do you suggest this COVID-19 is a catalyst? And is it a catalyst only for a few sectors or is irrespective of any other irrespective of sector? So is it implied for service industry, manufacturing, trader? Can you just take us through that?
Yeah. Yes, Sandeep. And thanks for giving me this opportunity. And Happy New Year, everyone who is listening to this webinar. I can not see many faces because, you know, camera is not on, but I can see the panelists. So as Sandeepa has rightly said, you know, this pandemic has hit at like from nowhere. And no company was having a faint of an idea, you know, even after November last year, if you see, that what is going to happen, you know, globally. Now, if you see the construct of SME or the entire business construct in India, you can fairly distinguish the company size differently in their technology aspects or their people, their ways of working, their expansion of businesses. So the impact of this pandemic was different for different organizations at different degrees. If you bifurcate them with their working patterns, yes, the factories had gone into lockdown and it was all stopped because labor were not there. It was a complete misnomer over there. But there are a few of the organizations who have got benefited out of it. So it depends on the industry where you are in. But one thing was very clear by thought leaders in when the response of was coming back to make the business normal or to adopt the next normal, one thing was very clearly defined and laid down as a foundation of paradigm shift, that things will not remain as they are today. So something has to be changed. Now, what has to be changed, how it has to be done when business is a continuous process? That was the idea, and people started, you know, taking up the first was the, you know, to accept that change is going to happen. Once this interaction has happened in 45 days, 30 days, when the financial attacks started really happening to these companies, then they said, okay, the only savior for any of the organization to do this business is to go digital. Now, if you see, the government was talking about go digital, you know, when GST came to India per se, you know, the adoption and awareness of, you know, go digital was happening. A lot of payment banks have started coming in. So there was an idea, but you know, in every company or country, you know, the adoption behaviors, the change leaders are different, and then there are some followers. Now, why is it as a catalyst? Because, you know, this given opportunity to all the organizations that they have to move it. So few of them might have faced that this is a forced adoption which they have to do. But yes, that chemical reaction has, you know, give them a catalyst change, and everybody has to move it. So that is why I call it as a catalyst. Now, you have asked about what degree of people would be, you know, getting impacted and how it will work. Yes, the combination of, you know, online and offline will work. But contactless security, safety of the employees would be of prime importance. So the companies who are service led have to build a, you know, remote sales process organization, wherein when the need is utmost to have a customer visit, right, that has to be done. Wherein there are a lot of companies who can still have a digital presence, they can also see this as an opportunity for, you know, look, grow, expand. There are no geographical boundaries now. So, you know, something has been taken away, but a lot of things, the plethora of things have been given to the platter. It is just, you know, how you are perceiving and doing this change, right? So first you have to make your mind that things will change. Then the things will change, you have to change accordingly. You have to build new skill sets in your people, right? You have to train them to adopt that thing. And then you have to be pretty, people are talking about cost effectiveness. I call it as a frugal. You have to become frugal. Frugal means spend your money wisely. Now, there are a lot of changes. People have started curtailing on their rental incomes, travel costs. Save this money and utilize in making a technology, because it is going to be there sooner or later. Everybody has to be there. But if we know that this is going to the change and people are talking, we have to spread awareness. Like Sandeepan, you are doing the right thing that you are bringing businesses to this platform, giving them an idea. The choice is with them, whether they want to adopt it today or after some time. But this has to happen.
Thanks, Nitin. And it's really good that actually you brought it, that people need to adopt technology. And that's very important for businesses to adopt technology. And Rajan has very clearly mentioned that one of the key focus of businesses, and specifically mid-scale or smaller scale businesses, need to look at technology, how it can help them to grow their businesses. So I think, can you please elaborate the usage of technology, how technology is important in creating the strategy for growing their businesses?
Thank you, Nitin, for setting a wonderful stage. He has really elaborated how businesses should look in the present time. And Sandeepan, your question is really relevant, that this is a big gap we find in the SMEs. One of the biggest challenges which I have seen in my course is that many of the entrepreneurs look at the wrong light for getting the guidance on technology. And the easiest example I want to take is the ventilator technology. India really need a ventilator. We still need ventilators. And the ventilator technology effectively is available between 15 to 20 lakhs of rupees globally, in Indian rupees. But unfortunately, in spite of talking to three companies, we couldn't find anybody to invest that money to get the technology. somewhere, if you ask very specifically what the SME I dream should look at, is to be able to spend money in the right place, taking a tip from what Nitin told, be frugal in the wrong place and be lavish in the right place. But unfortunately, we love to be lavish in the wrong place and we are frugal in the right place. To put the example very simply, you have a very loyal employee. I've seen many SMEs very reluctant to increase the salary. You see an employee working very much, you don't give him the technology to scale up his activity. Because he is hitting well with my hammer, we tell him you hit more with the hammer. We can give him a machine and then scaling up to the next activity. So when you talk of technology, I would love to see Indian SMEs investing. And in fact, I would appreciate both previous present governments who have brought in a lot of investment funds available for scaling up technology. And this government has done a lot of innovative way of funding technology. But I do not find many takers except for large companies, but that's not what we want. We want the SME to invest in the right technology to take the enterprise to the next level. And when we say the right technology, bringing in deeper technology of what they're doing, using their experience and insights to build the relevant technology to scale up their business and give their employees more scalability through use of technology. Yes, Sandeep.
Thanks, Rajan. I think it's very important. And I have personally seen a lot of businesses being in communication field. I have discussed a lot, okay, every business need to invest a little bit on having a web presence. But again, you see him coming out in an 80 lakhs car, but would not be very keen to invest on maybe 80,000 worth of website, which brings me to Mangal. She runs a digital marketing firm. And I think it's a watershed moment for all of us, specifically in digital field, because people realize the need to be on the web, to be available, to be present in the digital environment. What is a business should do to start looking at investing in on a digital presence, and how do they should go and amplify their presence there? Mangal, if you can just please share.
Good evening, all fellow panelists and visitors, viewers. Sandeepan, you hit the nail on the head when you said people hesitate to spend. You know, there's a story which I used to hear as a child. There's a miser in a small town. And he wears tattered clothes. So his neighbors ask him, you can afford to buy the most expensive garments, but why are you wearing tattered clothes? So he says, look, everybody in this town knows how well to do or how rich I am. Why do I need to invest in good clothes? And the guy who's asking the question is fed up and goes away. Then this man travels to a city to go and visit some business owners. So he is still dressed in the tattered clothes. So the same person asks him, why are you still dressed in tattered clothes? You're going to a city. He says, who will know me in that town? Nobody will know me. So why do I care to wear good clothes? So people find excuses, Sandeepan. They don't realize what they miss. You're very right. We have come across this many times. But my 2 cents or 2 rupees of wisdom is to say, having a digital presence puts you on a global platform, or it provides you the entire globe to do business with. If your business is the kind that can do business across, right? It removes the geographical limitations, one, and it provides information to those who are seeking, looking for it. Now, if people don't know what you're doing, how will they come to you? I'll give you a simple example. Today, I was looking for a South Indian restaurant in Indiranagar, not that I'm not aware of, in Bangalore. Not that I'm not aware of, but I just wanted to make sure that the places are open and doing business. A friend has come down from Delhi, a business acquaintance, and he wanted to go to a South Indian restaurant for breakfast tomorrow. And the first thing I did was Googled it. So Google has become a verb now. People search online for things that they want. Either they want to procure, or as an information that they want, or even just to put some, post some comments, or, you know, Google has, I mean, you've become so dependent on search engines. So if my business today is not searchable or not discoverable, then I'm, you know, then I'm losing business to my competitor who's been smart enough to position himself online. Now I'm only not only talking about a website, I'm talking about the presence across platforms or across websites. But the first and the foremost is my own media where I can say what I want about myself. So my website is the first primary thing that I should focus on. Provide all the right information. Who is behind the business? What do I sell? Or what do I, what kind of products do I sell and service? What is the time I'm open at? What is the time that I'm doing business? What are the days I'm closed? And there is a larger purpose. Do I have a purpose? For example, one of my clients is into healthcare products and sanitizers and, you know, cleaning material, herbal and very eco-friendly. So now her purpose is to be safe, to have an eco-friendly product. So the larger purpose also should be shown. And people who, those of them for whom this matters, they will definitely look for a product or a company like that. So there are various ways in which you can be present online. Obviously, website is one. The social media platforms like LinkedIn, Facebook, and other platforms. It's great to have your, you know, listing on about your office location. Yes, we are staring at a time when the office locations might vanish, but currently we still rely heavily on locations. Online reviews, a customer who has used your product or service, if he or she goes and gives you a social proof, that is invaluable. The digital ads, then the media, PR coverage, videos and image listings. YouTube is a powerful tool, and listing in business directories. So these are certain things if a business does, he or she does not have to worry about losing out. Yes, once the inquiry comes in, the capability and the costing and various other things will matter in closing the sale, but at least you will not miss out to your competition even without trying. So I think digital presence is essential, and those of them who are not concerned or not thinking about it will tend to lose out. Over to you, Sandeepan.
Thanks, Mangal. I think it's pretty important. And then this came out pretty well, in fact, with a lot of discussion which I have with multiple business owners, that digital presence is most of people acknowledging it. But again, as I told you, this 2019 is, the COVID-19 is one which is actually freezed many decision-making of businesses. And if you have gone through the article of Dr. Dindyal Swain, he has very clearly mentioned top 10 key skills which are needed for business right now, or a business owner to drive and get back to the business. So we may not have the time for all the top 10 to discuss right now, Dr. Swain, but can you just elaborate the top three, which is very pertinent for a business owner to focus to drive his business further?
Yeah, thanks, Sandeepanji. You know, like happy to be here to all of you, the panelists and the viewers. Wonderful work by they are doing an outstanding job. I compliment all the team members. My compliments to Sandeepanji and team for coming out with outstanding book, e-book, Game Plan 2021 and Vision 25. 25 outstanding personalities that are featuring in the book. So it's wonderful work. Having said that, let me give you a couple of data, and then you know I'll tell you the three important points, which is important. Because of this pandemic, COVID-19, 86.5 million cases that has happened world over, 48.5 million recovered, 1.87 million death. If you come to India, it is 10.4 million, which are cases, 10 million recovered, 150K, you know, like suffered death. If you talk about job loss, as per International Labour Organization, it is 50 million job loss in India. If you talk about the cumulative job loss in the entire world, it is 500 million. In India, amidst all you know these COVID-19 negatives and all those, one interesting thing that happened and that attracted my attention as a speaker and a coach is every human being out of 135 billion people, 1.3 billion, 135 crore people. I mean, either they have got now entrepreneurship skills or intrapreneur skills. So that's a big change that has happened. And I hope, you know, all of you will agree. 63.05 micro industry we have, 0.33 million small, and 5,000 medium industries we have. Few small data, couple of data. Global consumption loss has gone to $5 trillion. The global GDP is around 87.3 trillion US dollar. Wage loss happened at $3 trillion. So these are the complete scenario. But amidst all these negative things, 1,759 startups have been launched in 2020. And I am sure what the Honorable Prime Minister Sri Narendra Modi ji is having his vision of having $5 trillion economy, Indian economy by 2024. I'm sure it will be achieved because, you know, these are the situations which gives that push, you know, to think out of the box and go for extraordinary things. But these things are possible only when these three things which Sandeep Anji requested me to present. The first one is knowing self. It's not about money. It's not about any other, you know, like external issues. I understand when I make this statement as an entrepreneur, I'm also an entrepreneur. So I understand what is the value of working capital, fixed capital, and all those things. Money is very, very important for anything. But money is not the limiting factor. It's not the resource. It's rather resourcefulness. So for that resourcefulness, one has to be, especially, you know, I'm hinting towards entrepreneurs. One should know as an entrepreneur exactly what he is doing. Like, you know, there are many people who leave jobs and start business, you know, like do something, you know, like doesn't work, come to business. So are you this kind of, you know, like having this kind of intention, or are you really serious about creating an impact in the society? And if that is the case, then what is that threshold level, that integrity you'll be going to maintain to, you know, achieve your goal and also serve the society? So first is knowing self. And this COVID-19 has given us that time, that punch to know ourselves absolute in clear terms, because anyone who has got doubt will be going to have a tough time. Technology, money, and all those things will come automatically if you are very clear what exactly you are doing. Are you doing a me too business, or you are trying to do something to fill the gap in the society and you're serving the society? So to know this self, why you required, it is required for the entrepreneur to know this self, is to respond to the situations. The first issue that happens, in particular, I'm referring to entrepreneurship. The moment there is a problem, whether related to man, money, machine, material, time, or whatever, the first thing is 99% entrepreneurs, with due respect, because I respect a lot all the entrepreneurs, because entrepreneurs are outstanding gifts of this particular world. So my salute and respect to all the entrepreneurs in India, in particular, entire world in general. Because they're a different breed. They are the specific, you know, like gifts of God. So the moment there is an issue, 99% entrepreneurs doesn't know how to respond. We react normally. I might be included in that in my initial stage. So the moment you react, you lose that understanding of the issue. So it's not about, you know, everybody will go technology, and anybody who is not operating in technology platform will lose the business. When I speak this, I'm a digital marketer as well. So, you know, I speak it with the responsibility. So it's not like that. If you don't understand the structure, the process, the clarity of your entrepreneurial setup, you know, just having technology will not solve our purpose. So it's clarity, and it's how to respond to this situation. That's the first one. The second one is the self-belief. When this downturn happens, the first thing we lose is self-belief. So if you're superficial in your belief system, you'll be going to lose this. So I bring, you know, like this is my copyrighted concept, you know, lion leadership. Why, you know, in spite of a lion being a small cat, you know, he's not the fittest, he's not the biggest, he's not the tallest, but still, at the end of the day, he's the king of the jungle. Now, why that is so? Because of three things: thinking, feeling, and doing. Now, where entrepreneurs, you know, like face problem, it's because I think to be the very best, I don't feel the same way, and I don't do the activities which is required to be the very best. So only when an entrepreneur in particular, looking at our setup and like general public in general, when you, whatever you think, if you feel the same thing, if you do the same thing, then thinking, feeling, doing. If three things are in alignment, then your mind, body and soul is in alignment. Money will not be a problem. As an entrepreneur, I might not be a gigantic entrepreneur, but when I started my business, I started with zero and grown to a particular level. So I have seen these things. So when you go through step by step, brick by brick, so it's important that your belief system, what you think, you feel the same thing and you do the same thing. And last thing is your patience. A lot of patience is required. Anyone who lose patience will short of ideas. So if anybody wants to get plenty of ideas, it is that patience which will be going to bring that particular virtue. So knowing self, self-clarity, knowing how to respond, not to react. Second, what is very important is self-belief, lion leadership, lion belief system, thinking, feeling, doing should be same. And third one is lot of patience, so that you will be going to listen others on merit and you'll be going to learn new things. For the timing, these three, and I think rest will follow. Thank you very much. Over to you.
Absolutely, absolutely correct, Dr. Swami. Very important to be follow this thing. And also, which one point you really brought out is are you in the business of me too? Is something which, so most of the businesses I've seen, one product or one service is doing well. So they say, let me invest on similar kind of thing and start working. And Rajan has very mentioned very clearly, create a differentiator in your organization, to create a differentiator in your product and offering. And I will request him to just elaborate more. And maybe we can, this is some example, how if some of the organization he has worked with, or consultant have done, create a differentiator between themselves and a competition.
Sorry, can you just repeat that question a bit?
Yeah, I think you mentioned a lot about differentiator, to be a differentiator organization. So just like to understand, and if you can give some examples of some of the organization you have worked with, how they have created differentiation differentiation among their offerings or services or products.
Thank you. I'll give you an example of the call today with one of the former managing directors of a large public sector bank. So I told him that, and this has been my belief from my age of 14, since I decided to be an entrepreneur, and age of 17 when I've been employing people, is that never go to a client with only one service. This is the biggest concern in India, is a consultant comes with a defined service. I come to sell this to you. Now, why should I buy it from you? I ask people. Today, I sit as advisor, director, board representative in many corporates, and I ask them, why should I deal with you? He says, mine is the best service. It's like a parent telling that my child is the best child. This question of why deters people from even maybe picking up a phone and calling me again. And I love the people who ask why to me. Because if I cannot answer why, Sandeepan asked me a lot of why in my lifetime. I think I know him for 10 years, 7-8 years. And he's one of the toughest customers to sell something to. I've tried to sell a lot of things to him. He keeps, why? Because he's a great entrepreneur. It's very difficult to sell to great entrepreneurs. And if you cannot, and then you see Sandeepan has survived the relationship for 8 years. Sandeepan did not tell me that Rajan is a crazy guy. I should not deal with him. No, that's what good entrepreneurs are made of. We ask the question why. We may like the answer, may not like the answer, but still we continue the relationship because we never know. I never knew 8 years back that I would write an article for Sandeepan's book. And I'm sure Sandeepan would also never have thought this because I was in Cochin in a very laid back town when we first met. And today I'm in Mumbai and we met in Delhi many times. So now what is a differentiator? Now, if I would say what is a differentiator is the change of location is the differentiator. Yesterday, an entrepreneur told me I shifted from Kottayam to Cochin. I told, congratulations. You are going to be young by 10 years. Because the differentiator comes when you are able to try something innovative. Now, when you go to a client, he looks something innovative from you. Because I would take again a leaf from what Mangal has told, that you can portray the best website. There's nothing wrong. You should portray. But then, are you able to deliver at least 75% of what you're portraying? I tell people 25% you can always oversell yourself, but you cannot 90% oversell yourself. So the biggest differentiator is taking a sentence from the great actor Rajinikanth in Tamil, Solva Seiva, Seiva Solva, which means do what I tell and tell what I do. This is the biggest challenge globally. When I go, they say, Rajan, are you really Indian? I say, yeah. But then you are delivering. Why? Because when your case, they have come across instances, I don't say country specific, in many of the international transactions, we overcome it. So first differentiator is delivering. When we say we have technology, we should have technology. Many a case when the due diligence is done on technology, we have good due diligence in legal and finance. But to me, the biggest due diligence is on technology and operation. So the biggest differentiator every entrepreneur should carry, one, being true to what he's talking so that he can deliver. Two, being able to give more than the competition. Three, the most crucial thing, which I have loved during the last 8 months, is the ability to collaborate with the best of the world, not with the worst of the world. When you work collaboratively with the best of the world, there's only one way, and that is to moon. If we are going to work collaboratively with a guy who will say, yes, boss, yes, boss, yes, boss, I'm sure that Sandeepan would not have called me in a meeting today. We would have lost the connect. Sandeepan knows very well. I always question what he is doing. Even though he has not given me permission, still I ask him, that how is it going? When are you going to make it big? When are you going to make it a 1 billion SMB connect? Because I know personally by heart that I told Sandeepan 8 years back that Sandeepan is doing something which is very close to my heart. But he has got a long way to go, but he's doing something very close to my heart, which is the need of India. But to sell it to the entrepreneur, to get more people on board, is a different story, and which he's working on relentlessly. But every time I talk to him, I get energized to see. We both studied in a Kendriya Vidyalaya, so I'm very proud that, you know, he's put in his effort, kept his commitment, makes our alma mater happy. So the differentiator which you see in Sandeepan, if all the people listening can Google about what he has done, the effort he has put in, join SMB Connect, and deliver what we are promising, that would make a great nation and a great enterprise. And that should be our differentiator, to deliver more than competition, to collaborate with better people, and to deliver what we are promising.
Great, Rajan. I think it's thanks. Good that we are recording it, and we can use it to tell people what SMB Connect is all about. It's really, really appreciate the nice word. And I remember the first call we had where you when my team called you and you ask who is doing this, which is something is there in your head and you want to do that. When we came a long way to have this leadership going, great. Now let me ask and carry on this session. And before I ask my next question to Nitin, let me tell all the audience that the ebook is available, will be sent across to all of you on your email, or will be also a link also will be available in the chat box for you to download. So Rachna, my team member, will do that needful. So you can always download this ebook, which will be available to you right now or next few minutes on the chat box, or it will be mailed to you later once this session gets over. So now let me ask this question to Nitin. Nitin, you have a large team, and you are also talking about managing the remote sales process. So how do you do that? Because this is a challenge, because selling is predominantly known as one-on-one affair, where you have a personal one-on-one meeting and you do this have this relationship going and have the sales with them. Now, how do you do a sale, set up a remote sales process so that your business doesn't get affected because of this lockdown and restricted movement? Nitin?
That was me on mute. So before I move on to the question which you have asked, I just wanted to summarize what brilliant thoughts I have just noted down. And for the benefit of all, what I've understood is that, as Dr. Deen Dayal has said, once the purpose is clear of an entrepreneur, why he wants to do it, what and how, money and other material things would definitely come. So purpose has to be there, the clarity of thoughts. And when the clarity of thoughts is there and the alignment of the purpose is there, success is bound to happen. It will come. Now, when you know what you're doing, then coming to the business aspect of it, the three things which I think Mangal will also appreciate, and we have been listening it from so many years, for to get a business success, three things are required. One is the awareness part of it, which Sandeepan is doing greatly to the SMEs. Like, if I have to do something, I need to be aware of it, what is going to my contemporaries, what is going in the global environment. And in this time when there is no geographical foundations are happening, so we should know what China is doing, China plus one strategy, what is China plus one strategy. You know, we should know all these things. So one is, awareness. Once you're through with awareness, with the clarity of purpose, okay, this is what is fitting to me. The second thing is that I should come up with an affordable solution. Whatever you're selling an idea, you're selling a product. When you're making it affordable, definitely the innovation will come into the picture, as Mr. Rajan has mentioned, that there should be some niche of, some USP of your offering has to be there. And whatever you're saying, you should be pretty confident of going out and selling it. Because the people, once they decide that they are going, either there are two types of people now. One would be the go corporate. I'm an SME, but I have an ambition to go corporate. These are the right side of people where you should spend your time. And there would be some people who will say, I'm happy with sustain SME. So now there, with this COVID pandemic, there is nothing called sustain SME. Either you have to go up or you will perish. So there you have got no other choice, right? Now, once you've decided this, you have to put a lot of patience while innovating solutions, right? Making your offering, put a lot of hard work there. And then you have to create awareness. As Mangal has rightly said, okay, digital platforms, how should I go out and talk to the people, connect to the largest heterogeneous audience, right? I cannot sell my idea sitting in India and selling to in UAE. There's a time difference. There's a lingo difference. There are etiquettes, mannerism difference, right? So you have to, do the cosmetic changes while you are going it. So you have to be pretty aware of what needs to be done. So affordability, availability, and awareness. Once you have come to these three pointers, the most important thing is that, as you said, that it is about every great organization happens with the great people. As Rajanji was mentioning the example, that somebody, if he is using the hammer, if somebody is giving a better tool to do it, he will become more productive out of it. So invest in your people, right? You are investing in the share which you don't know what is going to happen. But people who are working with you for donkey years could do, brilliant work for you. So first and foremost, when you have the patience, as a leader, you should say, okay, a lot of people have gone job cuts. Sir has given a data of, 50 million job cuts in India. But there are a lot of budding entrepreneurs who say, okay, we all will take the pay cuts as this is going to be longer. So we are going to stay together. Whatever will come, we will see. So this is the greatest idea of an entrepreneur, that he's trusting on himself and on the people. Once you have made up a team, then you have to say, okay, now the current skill sets will not take you where we want to go. It's a game change. The run rate and equation have got changed, right? So we have to bat differently, or we have to bowl differently. Now, the best way when we know is there is no absolute contact with people, but still I have to talk and interact with people. So can the technology help me in doing this? So this is the first thing which we need to tell them. Behavioral change has to come. Then we have to set up a remote sales process. Now, what will happen to the remote sales process? It will be different for different companies. So now if you bifurcate few of the larger organizations, they have already changed their supply chain management stuff. I think in the last your launch webinar, a few of the gentlemen were talking about, there are a lot of larger companies who have made some super stockist, new businesses are coming as a super stockist, and the supply chain management has been taken care of. But we are talking about SMEs. where the poor guy is having 5 to 8 salesmen. They go out, they collect the orders, and they come in. Now, can I give a tool to my customers and to my sales team who can utilize this by through a B2C website or a B2B application where you're collecting the orders? So how you can grow sales? Not losing the orders. It will not happen that while you're adopting a technology, your 100 orders will become 200 orders. But it will help you to grab all those 100 orders and it will not go to competition. One. Secondly, you can optimize your inventory. Third, while you're sitting and you're cutting your time on travel, right? You can have the patience to look the data and analytics. What are my top cities? What are my fast moving items which are going there? And those analytics will help you in giving the right decisions at the right point in time. So this is a step-by-step process wherein first adopt a technology which suits you best, right? Secondly, once the purpose is clear, secondly, train your manpower. And now the training means it's not on the whims and fancies what I want to do. It is also what is the customer preference. Now you're doing a global webinar. You prefer GoToWebinar tool. I like Zoom. Somebody might be liking Google Hangouts. So as a seller, I should be equipped with everything because customer is still going to be the king. In Dubai, if WhatsApp call is video call is not allowed, it is not allowed. So I have to do a Zoom call. You may like it or not like it. So change accordingly. If they work on Sundays, they have a Friday holiday, make your team changes like this if you're going to grab that global opportunity. So you have to set up your teams. You have to see what is running in the market. Train your people on all those aspects. Invest on a lot of people. And when it becomes of utmost of importance that, one thing is that you have set up this thing, but now you have to train your people to sell over phone. The idea is to sell. So then selling skills, the newer skill sets will come. A lot of training, a lot of coaching, mentoring has to be there. That requires patience. Somebody who was productive with say 5 sales per month or 550 lakh rupees of turnover, his capacity while selling over a phone or on the internet would reduce to say 20%. Entrepreneur should feel it's a different ball game. He's not running on a road. Now he's climbing the Himalayas. Right. So that is the patience part, which sir was mentioning. So if you put all these things, so 2020 was the year of survival, which we have run through. Now with the aid of vaccination, this is the year to master the new skills, setting up the new businesses, processes, which are best suited for you. But change has to happen. And this is the time when you do it. In 2022, Q2, start seeing some profit coming in. But if you will not do it and you still feel that you are a sustained SME, it is not going to be there. You have to think like a go corporate, have the largest ideas, have the purpose of your business very clear, what you want to do, and then utilize the tools. There are a lot of people who are willing to handhold you for this purpose because their business is also consulting, so they will help you. So collectively, I think Brand India will survive because we still believe in relationships. We still believe that Vasudev Kutumbakam. We believe that if I am having a leisure, my neighbor should also have money to leisure because we want to celebrate. So it might be different in other part of the country, but in India, I think there's a good, great hope light is there that we can do it. So in nutshell, and just to give you the final pointers, that first thing, identify your areas of expertise, train your people, train them to sell through the different technology platforms. And then last not the least, if that face-to-face time is required, then go and do it. For service industries, it has to be like this only. Even if you see, if you buy for yourself, a lot of things, if I bought a double bed, you have to go out and showroom. But now I've started using through online. The people came in, I saw the design and videos, everything. As Mangal was mentioning, YouTube can give you a better idea of all these angles. I've seen the product, I've seen the reviews, everything. I gave the order, money transferred. it got delivered at my place, and after 2 days, guys came with proper PPE kits and everything. They installed it. Job is done. This is the business. This is the business. And this order came from somewhere from Jodhpur, Rajasthan. Right. So people are becoming, they have adopted, they have shut down their online their stores, and they are doing online businesses. They have curtailed their operations only in Jodhpur, and through the web presence, they are doing the business.
Great. I think this is something, it's a lot of innovation I also heard, and which is where I think Mangal may need to share her expertise, because a lot of people don't know how to engage with their audience, with their prospective people on an online or on a digital way. So if you can just share some light on that, it would be really good.
So thanks, Sandeepan. Engagement is, most of us use social media tools for one-way communication. But even one-way communication can keep the customers engaged if we provide value. If our website is the nucleus of our business and it answers all the questions that my customer might have, I'm still providing him value. And that is a method of engaging. When I keep providing value, and it works both ways. It works for the customer or the visitor to the website. It works for me because I'm propagating the information. But the best way to do this will probably to have a budget for creating content which can be disseminated through various points. Your book itself is one method of disseminating useful information, which could help the businesses, and it can help service providers also, correct? Now, a couple of other things what we can do is, if you look at most business entities, B2B or otherwise, they finish 70% of their research before they come to a vendor, right? Which are the platforms from where they consume information? LinkedIn, I have realized, is a great tool or great platform for B2B. Enterprise customers are always there. And there are methods to engage with them. While the company can share its information from the company page, the moment the owner or the leadership, the key leadership team starts sharing it, there is more engagement, there is more traction. And one key thing I would like to tell, share with all of you is, this is, the platforms are meant to share information, share your views. So the best way to get engaged is to start a conversation. If your acquaintance or your business counterpart has written an article, share your views on it, because each one of us has a view, but every one of us has an angle to it, angle at which we look at it, an angle in which we use the information. So sharing this information helps. Another way to do it is to share your case studies. A very powerful tool, Nitin would agree with me. Powerful tool when you showcase a way in which a tool, a software technology, or a fund can be used, or how somebody else has used. And that can become a massive way, not only to share the information, but also to have people vibe with it. The moment people vibe, there starts a conversation. Basically, engagement is nothing but a conversation between two entities. And this can be done in many ways. Some of them are also to invest in a listening tool. Yes, it's pretty expensive right now, but as technology advances, I think it will become less expensive. Being able to gather information from across the web on what people are saying about your brand. Is somebody saying something? That can be another method. And then you respond. Twitter is used very effectively by many people because that's a place where you can actually have a conversation. There are various other things that can be done. Many influencers are another way to start the engagement going. You are talking to your target audience, who is the follower of an influencer, right? You share your information with the influencer, facilitate conversation, and he or she does it for you. One of our previous companies has used it brilliantly. Chartered accountants who keep recommending Tally, right? So that is basically an engagement. You engage with the CA and the CA engages with his or her clients where there is an engagement, right? Three-way connect. These are some of the things which I can straight away think of. Showcasing the expertise is another method. And that's where people come back to you with queries and questions. Thanks, Sandeep.
I know if you want to go and talk about how you can engage the digital person, to take another session to do that. Maybe which people were keen to know can reach you directly. We are about to have time, but we would like to ask Dr. Swain is, there are times, and Nitin has put it very clearly, because last year was a time versus more of survival. This year is again adopting the current new normal. How do you keep yourself motivated and your team so that to get profit in Q2 of 2022, as Nitin is saying? So difficult for a business person, because to get the team motivated, ensure monies are not coming in, the sales are not at that level. So Dr. Swain, tell me, how do I keep motivated myself and my team?
This too will pass. So, life is a long journey. This will pass. But, you know, what is important, rather than, going to the team, I will focus on leaders. Because the leader's enthusiasm and spirit will decide whether the team will be there. As the famous saying goes, a team of ships led by a lion will always win, than a team of lions led by a sheep. So whether the leader, whatever he thinks, feels, and does, those things are very important. Here I will tell you, leaders need to learn a lot. This COVID-19 has taught all of us, even as a professor or a speaker, I have started learning a lot, because the more you learn, the more ideas you'll be going to generate, and you will understand the world perspective. So learning is must, and all SMEs, whether entrepreneurs or even general people, laws and tax laws, all these things has to be, updated. Because most of the times, Ranjanji is there. Now, the moment you talk about tax affairs, we give it to chartered accountants and others. But it's okay. You can give them, because they are the experts and they're the masters. But you also, you need to understand what exactly the system is, the process is. If you close your eyes, then, because as an entrepreneur, you need to learn and know a lot beyond a general person. So anybody who is learning a lot, knowing a lot, will be going to survive, because he'll be going to have innovative ideas. Number one, the leader has to work on his health. Because why I'm talking about leader, because once the leader is in shape, mind, body, and soul, then only the team will be in shape. Because if the leader is disturbed, then he'll not be going to, because once you yourself is an issue, how come you'll be going to solve customers' issue and your team's issue? So that's the first thing. And I've seen in the market, while doing a lot of coaching, the leaders are going through tremendous psychological blow. One side family, one side money, one side their own thing, other side the team numbers gradually going down, the other side, a lot of issues. And on the top of that, a lot of tax laws changing, and laws changing. So these are all very, the challenging times for the leaders. The second thing which is important for me is prospecting has to go up by 500 times. But more than prospecting, closing is very important. So find out your segment, consolidate, prepare your, particular segment, target them very, very carefully, close the deal. Because what happens, it's not about the database. It's not about the data. It's not about the analytics. It's about how closely, how quickly you close. I'm not talking about the factors of automation, man, money, machine, material, inventory, supply chain. So those are all, detailed things which we can look into. And the to do all this, content management is very important, whether offline or online. So I will focus on that. And finally, I can tell, anyone who is having tremendous faith on God will be going to have an easy time. It's the blind faith, even now faith. Everything goes wrong, still things will improve, and it will work for wonders. And I'm sure with this kind of experience which our panelists, esteemed panelists having, or the audience is even having, and we have seen live, it's only faith at the end of the day. I mean, that doesn't discount the hard work and, you know, the nitty-gritties of business. I'm not telling that. Conditions apply. So those things will automatically go, because otherwise you are not an entrepreneur, right? But along with that, if you don't have faith at the end of the day, and that is even now faith, unconditional faith, then it's very difficult to survive, because you will be going through a lot of turmoils. Specifically, I'm telling about entrepreneurs. Whatever you say at the end of the day, you know, like even after this webinar, you'll be thinking about your ROI. So, you know, so this is a typical, that's the reason entrepreneurs have blessed people on this earth. God has selected entrepreneurs because he knows these are the people who can handle stress of life. General people will not be able to handle so much of stress. So stress is blessing for entrepreneurs. Over to you.
Thanks, Dr. Swain. I think it's so with this, we would like to wind up. This is very motivational. The leader should lead from the front, as they say. We've just overshot our time. There are a couple of questions, but I will suggest we take these questions and pass on to the panelists, and they will revert on email, because let's keep our timing as per the schedule we have. So before I thanks our esteemed panelists, let me just do a small announcement that as part of the promotion of this ebook, our next webinar is on 15th of Jan. We will have a panelist consisting of Mr. Vijay Prakash, who is General Manager for NSIC. We will have Mr. Deepak Soni, he is a senior entrepreneur. We will have Nandya Mishra, who is founder and managing director of AM Legal, based out of Ahmedabad. Mr. Deepak Goyal, he is the group CEO of Digital Next, one of the digital marketing expert in education field. And Josna Fotidar, who is a professional training consultant and a coach. So these five panelists will be available on 15th of January. So please share this information to your friends and peers. And if you are available, you can please join us. So thank you very much, all of you. Thank you, my panelists, Mangal, Nitin, Rajan, and Dr. Swain, for making this a very interactive session. And I hope to see you again in some form or others at the SMB Connect Forum. So thank you, ladies and gentlemen, and hope you have a great year ahead.
Thanks a lot. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Bye-bye.